Good morning. How many of you would admit to being a foodie? I'm glad. There's some people that are like in denial. Like, I'm not a foodie. I have to say that especially St. Teresa Church is a foodie church. We seem to do a lot of things around food. I mean, look at the ladies, for example, people in the church here today, I can see some of you, and when I look at you, I connect you to a food that I've eaten with you. I mentioned this in the previous mass, so this is gonna be consistent. For example, Barbara Stanishevsky and her cherry cake that has lady fingers all around it like this, and it's like cream cheese all over. I will always connect Barbara Stanishevsky with her cheesecake, with her cherry cheesecake, and the cupcakes of Sharon Jackson. I gotta tell you, Pat, last night when you made that chicken that is so crunchy on the outside and so moist on the inside, now I look at you and I'm saying, chicken. It's just the way it is. It's just the way it is, right? So it's, I'm a foodie, yeah. That's why I'm so, I get fat quickly because I'm a foodie. Nick and Ron knows that. We're both foodies. So it is this idea about being a foodie, and I'm telling myself, wow, how nice it is that if we want to make memories with people, we get connected to specific food that we partake. Huh? And not only in the area of sharing the food, because if you want to, one of the I think most amazing things that I thought of doing in the beginning when I came here to St. Teresa was the Feed Your Pastor program. Do you remember that? That was awesome because I got to know many parishioners that way. And it's so beautiful how, like, through food, and it's cultural to me too, how through food we really get to know everybody at the table. We get to share the meal and we become immediately close and we become more united together in the meal. But I think it's also true not only in that area, but also in the area of, I will remember always the people based on the food that are given, that they have shared with me. I think that goes back to the roots of my own personal life. It goes back to my mother. Why I love my mother so much is because whenever I think of her, I think of the food that she has cooked for me. You know your own mothers and fathers and grandmothers and your friends, right? Do you remember that immediately when you're a mom and you always eat apple pies and whatever it is that your mom has cooked for you? That is also especially true for me, but I think with me, the power of that is even much more, I think, in some ways, because I remember when I was in high school, and this is one of the memories I have that is foundational to my own spiritual life. When I was in high school, I was first year and second year high school. That was the time when my dad left the house and my parents separated at that point officially. And my mother had to fend for her children on her own. In other words, in the Philippines, we don't have this thing called, you know, child support. We don't do that legally in the Philippines. And so the parent that's left behind with the children becomes like the one who's responsible for the children. And since because of that, I think I have an appreciation even more of what my mother has done for the three children. I remember, especially during the first several months of this, and my mom had to figure out what to do. And she came up with food. I'm going to raise you three kids with food, by food. So she started cooking. Early in the morning, she decided to start cooking. Made this delicious, our Filipino version of a pierogi, stuffed empanada. And then we have the rice balls that are caramelized outside. We wake up in the morning like, what is that? That's so good. Kind of like the egg roll, yeah. And she does an egg roll to a version of egg rolls. She does all kinds of different things. And from that day forward, my everyday routine to go to school was, I carry this big Tupperware, like this, transparent Tupperware, this size, filled with all of my mom's goodies, and I carry them to school, like this. And I take them to the school cafeteria, and I drop it off there so that they would sell it to the cafeteria, and after school, I would pick up this huge Tupperware, and go home with money instead of Tupperware. That's one of the ways that my mom helped manage to raise the children on her own. And can I just do a footnote and say that I for a 13, 14 year old kid, first year, second year high school, you thought that that would be like, I was worried, would be like, will I look good with Tupperware? How could I ever possibly date someone at school with going in and out there with Tupperware? I gotta tell you this though, young ones, I didn't realize how attractive that is for some girls. Oh yeah, Tupperware, rocket, you know, rocket. Back to the point here, back to the point, sorry. So, I have to tell you that that's exactly what I did for the rest of the time that I was in high school. But it all started because my mother did that. And I remember that first day, and it happened from the very first day and every day that followed. We would wake up early morning to the smell of this delicious rice cake and rice water, caramelized, delicious food. And we won't have to worry. All we had to do was fix ourselves and take care of shower and brush our teeth and then get ready for breakfast. And we sat down. We would sit down by the table, and my mom would take up this tray, our own share or whatever is on the Tupperware. We have that for us to eat every day. And I will never forget it because it, in my own little mind, at first year, second year high school, I literally saw the hand of God in my mom's food. It felt like God's hand was coming down from the heavens, dropping that food at the heart, at the middle of the table, and then we didn't have to worry about anything. But it was my mom's food. And it was one of those channeled providence that made me think of how much I loved at a very young age. And whatever food my mom cooked during that time, it went straight into my heart. And that is why I love my mom so much, is because at the time when we really, really needed that assurance that God was there, that God was taking care of us, it was my mother that was the incarnation of God for us three children. So today, I remember how the power of food, I remember the power of food and what that can do in making us understand that God loves us. And so today, I think if we translate that to what goes on in the table of the Lord, you know, the Eucharist is given to us by Jesus Christ at a big price. At a big price. The Eucharist was given to us as food of life, bread and wine transformed into the body and blood of Christ. And you know what that is? What it had to take? His ultimate sacrifice on the cross. That was not an easy offering on the part of God. That by feeding us, he had to completely give of himself in order to be partaken in the table of the Eucharist. So I always wonder, how is it even possible for us to not love God or to not have an appreciation of what Jesus has done on the cross and in the giving of the of his body and blood as food and drink for our spiritual journey. So I always look at the table of the Lord and said, this is where, over and over again, we are made to feel that the hand of God is upon us to sustain us and to nourish us and to give us life. How is it possible to take that in any way other than that's amazing? But not only in the area of the providence of God, but here's the other very special thing. I remember my brother and my sister and myself eating around the table, and my mother telling us, okay, remember kids, how much God loves you. See, we have food. We may be poor, but we have food. I remember how we all look at each other like, smile. And we all grew up to be the people that we are now. My sister finished education. My brother finished education. I became a priest. She is in Glendale Heights, doing very well with three kids and a loving husband. I am here in Kankakee with loving parishioners, doing very well in the three parishes, although it's hard, it's great, it's amazing. And my brother is in Africa, on a cargo ship, chef of a cargo ship. And every time we communicate through Facebook or through Viber or through whatever means that we communicate, I feel as connected with my sister and with my brother. And I love them both. And you know what makes me love them both is because we shared the common experience of being at that table. That we saw how much God loves us, all three of us. We will always be forever connected by what we've seen together because of my mom's food. And that is why also other than the fact that we are recognizing how much God loves us, when we share together the banquet of the Lord in the Eucharist, how can we not look at each other and say, hey, we're sharing this common experience of being fed by the loving arms of God. Now I have a part of you in me, and you have a part of me in you. How can we not go to one another and say to each other, I know you, I love you, and I appreciate you, and you'll always have a place in my heart just because we've shared the same banquet. We are all partakers of the love and the generosity of God. It is so easy to miss these points every day if you never pay attention to them. And that is why I think, just like the Lord Jesus Christ, in the second reading passage, who calls us to the wisdom of God, I think on the part of all of us who partake the Eucharist every time we gather together is this. Don't take these holy, beautiful, and generous things for granted. Never ever take these holy things for granted.